Just take us through your round. You had a nice recovery after the two bogeys. Talk about that stretch.
I didn't have the best start. I got a ruling on the 10th, which was my first hole, and made bogey on 11. And it was kind of not the start that I wanted to, but I made two birdies in a row, then in the middle of my first, and then made some more bogeys in the back nine, and then made two birdies in a row again. So yeah, I think today if I needed to make birdie was two in a row.
You said you didn't like getting off to a birdie start, so you probably weren't that worried.
Yeah, I wasn't that worried. It's I don't really like a birdie start, but if I get it, I won't say anything about it because birdie's obviously not a bad thing.
Yep.
Putting let you down in the middle of the round, but you got it back by the end. What changed for you?
I was putting well in my front nine. I did miss some putts, and then I missed a short putt in the middle of my back nine. But I think I kind of got my confidence back after making a birdie, coming off a bogey.
Talk about where you're situated on the leaderboard and what you're going to have to do to track down the likes of Indy Park.
Indy shot an amazing score, 6-under, I think, today. She's obviously right now the one to catch. But I just got to play my own game and hopefully get some more putts rolling in and reduce some bogeys because I had a couple of silly bogeys out there today.
It's nice that when your mediocre round is 69.
Yeah, I know. 1-under is 69. I wouldn't have thought that, but it could have been worse.
Does this feel like Vancouver? Like, what are the parallels from last year to this year?
I had a pretty average round on the third round last year, and I was okay, and I was still a shot leading going to the last round. So I guess it's a whole different feeling, and because I know I've already won it, I think it kind of gives me more pressure thinking that I actually could do it. But at that time, I was like, no way I'm gonna win it anyway. So yeah.
I've never opened a round with a birdie, but what's not to like about that?
When I saw, I either go and play really low like I did yesterday. That happened to me in Hawaii. I had a birdie on the first hole, and then I shot 6-under. But then if not, then I kind of have a mediocre round. It's never really been better than even unless I shoot something like 6 or 5-under.
Is there one hole on this course that's more troublesome than the others?
No, I don't think so. I don't think there was a bogey that I made yesterday, and I did it again today. So some of the driving holes are quite hard because it sometimes gets narrow. But it's obviously the golf course wasn't made for you to shoot 10-under or something. Yeah.
Can you talk real quick just about your caddy? I know you mentioned it earlier in the week, but you've been using a lot of local caddies wherever you've kind of been popping around. You don't travel with one. Talk about how Bruce has helped you this week and just kind of the process that you go through getting to know your caddies and how much they've helped you.
The last couple of caddies, local caddies, we've kind of did club selection and stuff together. This time, I decided I wanted to make the decision, so Bruce doesn't know what club I'm hitting, and he's most of the time helping, if the breeze gets up or looking at the slopes of the green.
Sure.
I think that the only different thing about other local caddies was I was actually sharing what club to hit, and sometimes it was good and sometimes it wasn't, so I decided I wanted to be more independent, and then doing it this way, it actually helps me learn to know my clubs better.
Sure.
So I think it's a really good opportunity that way.
Very cool.
All right, thank you.
Great.
Thank you,
Lydia. Thanks, Lydia.